Hi, I'm Chris. I'm excited to welcome you to today's session about navigation in KUKA.Sim. During this session, you will learn how to orientate yourself in KUKA.Sim and other useful shortcuts, which is an essential skill for any user. Let's start right away. So, for example, if you go to the upper left corner to the little drop-down menu here, you can customize your quick access bar by clicking on every single one of these little points. And then what you actually get is a little toolbar with a new layout, an open of file, a save and save as of your current project, and the undo and redo button. This is really helpful. It might be that this ribbon is here down under the other features, but actually it's really useful there. If you, for example, destroyed your whole layout and you cannot see your simulations view anymore, you can either drag and drop it into their original position, or you can click here on Restore Windows. And actually then it will change the windows back to the original position and you can see the simulation like that. In addition to that, you have another drop-down menu where you can actually show other features and menus that might be collapsed. Now let's get into the navigation part. If you want to select an object, you can click on them with the left mouse click on the object, left click, and then you have a bunch of different options here. For example, fill selected, where you directly jump to the object so it fills the whole simulation view. I will do the same with the robot. Here we jump to the robot. And in addition to that, if you want to turn around the robot, you click on the right mouse and you hold it, and then you move it around this over the screen, and thereby you rotate around the object. If you want to zoom in and out, you do this by the scroll wheel on your mouse, and you can get closer and farther away from the object. If you want to jump to another object, you click on Control and the right click of the mouse. So this is actually the same as fill selected, and with that you can again rotate around the object. If you want to have a smooth zoom, you click on Shift and then on the right mouse click and hold and move your mouse and transition. And if you want to see everything in the view, you click on all here on the little icons, so you see all the objects in your simulation. Now if you want to have translational movements, you have two options. Either you click on the mouse wheel and move your mouse translationally as you're used to, or and the other option is actually to click on both the left and the right mouse and to hold it and then again move your mouse accordingly to the image in your simulation. In addition to that, you have on the bottom left this different views that you can select from the above, from the side, from the bottom, or from the left or the right side. You can also select views in between or from the bottom. But this is very useful actually if you have a favorite view to jump back to the simulation.
Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to see more interesting videos about KUKA's simulation world, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Looking forward to seeing you in the next video.
Industrial intelligence.